Yes.
Let's maintain the circle.
Guys, let's maintain the circle. Let's maintain the circle.
Comrades, we are being requested tafadhali between the speeches pige vuvuzela ya chini.
Yes.
Sichape vuvuzela sana, it interrupts my speech. Thank you.
And there's also a request that we maintain our circle. So we'll sing a song as we wait for that circle to be made. 1, 2,
make a circle. 1, 2,
make a circle.
Vivo,
make a circle.
1, 2,
make a circle.
1, 2,
make a circle.
1, 2,
make a circle.
Thank you, thank you.
When the union is spiritual, there can be no power greater anywhere beneath the sun. It was born on earth is weaker than the field was ever won. For the union makes us strong. Solidarity.
Na hiyo sio kelele. Viva isti.
Comrades, power!
Power!
Comrades, rear!
Rear!
Comrades, power!
Power!
Comrades, CBA!
CBA!
Comrades, internship!
Internship!
Comrades, CBA!
CBA!
Comrades, strike!
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 Today marks the 48th day of our strike, and we are not seeing any end soon. And therefore, I will ask all the doctors to re-energize, to be ready to stay at home. Because this strike, we join the government who have been on strike for the last 7 years. So government has been on the strike for 7 years and 48 days. We've just been on the strike 48 days. So we have still a long way to go for the government to submit our rights. We know very well that we have a collective bargaining agreement that was signed after 100 days strike. I want to tell all of us, it will not take 50 days strike to have it implemented. It may take 100 days to have it implemented. It may take 200 days. It may take a year or so. But we are ready and we will continue. We are at a time of no turning back. We are at a time of no surrendering.
Yes.
Maybe they are waiting for us to get tired. But we cannot get tired.
Yes.
Getting tired is not part of our vocabulary.
Never.
Because we can always go on and on until the time they say they are ready to implement our CBA.
Yes.
We have had meetings with government, and government is dishonest.
Yes.
They are not ready to implement CBA, yes. And they are giving promises that they are not ready to keep. Because we are telling them that there is no any way you can give us a promise when you are violating the CBA outrightly before us. You can't tell us we pay the basic salary arrears when you can't pay intern doctors as per CBA.
Wow.
You can't tell us that you're going to post doctor interns as per the SRC circular that has been stopped by the court. Yet we know very well that you are not ready to do so. So we are saying as a union that we'll continue being on strike until government gets ready to implement CBA and post interns as per collective bargaining agreement.
Yes.
That they must pay them as we negotiated.
Yes.
We are not ready to negotiate payments of salaries.
Mm.
We are not ready to have that CBA violated.
Yes.
We must also say we have doctors who are enslaved in level 5 and level 6 hospitals.
Yes.
Government has been saying they don't know these doctors.
Mm.
Yet these are the doctors running rotors in Kenya National Hospital, in KUTRH, where we have rogue leaders, where we have rogue lady who is managing the board. We are saying no. They have been firing doctors, but one thing that we kept on saying, that there's no amount of victimization, there's no amount of threats, there's no amount of firing, there's no amount of sacking that will make us go back to work. What we are demanding is one thing, that CBA must be respected, must be implemented, must be protected.
Yes.
It is not only for interns, but it is for every doctor in this country.
Yes.
It is not only for doctors, it is for all the public servants.
Yes.
Because if they succeed in violating our CBA, I must say that there is no CBA which will be safe in this country. There is no one who will be safe.
No one.
As long as a legitimate government is coming out to violate a CBA, it means that they respect no worker. They don't respect doctors, they will not respect anybody else. So we are in this thing for long. We are in this thing until the government is ready to implement the CBA.
Yes.
We are going to back down, we are going to surrender, and our strike continues.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Yes, yes.
Doctors, viva!
Viva!
Doctors, viva!
Viva!
Thank you. Now, my name is Dr. Charles Mukwaya. I am the General Secretary of the Trade Unions Congress of Kenya, and I speak on behalf of all public service trade unions in this country. We agreed yesterday that we join the doctor's strike as from today. All public servants in this country resolved that they are going to join the doctors as they push for their CBA to be implemented. We are saying this because once the doctor's CBA is allowed to be bastardized, the rest of the public servant CBAs will never be respected. And so our message is very clear to the government. Respect, first accept that the doctor's CBA is legitimate as it was signed, implement it as it was signed, and implement it in total. Once you do that, the rest of the ideas will now come on the table. Number two, we are joining doctors in this business because the government is threatening all of us in the public service. When the government is casualizing labor in this country by converting permanent and pensionable members of staff, employees in the public service to contract that is casualizing labor. You cannot send a doctor who is serving in Kenyatta National Hospital, for example, and you want to give him to serve on contract, and he is enjoying permanent and pensionable terms. And so as long as the government is threatening public servants in that direction, as public servants, we will stand with the doctors, we will defend the doctors, we will defend the public servants.
Yes.
Yes.
Number two, the government must stop giving threats and intimidations. We are a country governed by law. We have one of the most progressive constitutions. Kenya has ratified very many ILO conventions. And all these provide structures and organs for partners, social partners, to sit and discuss and negotiate, engage in social dialogue under the tripartite committee arrangement. Why is Moses Kuria making declarations on the roadsides? Why can't he face the unions in a structured dialogue and be able to bring whatever proposal that he has so that we engage in it? But as long as they threaten and give those roadside declarations, we are here to stand with the doctors. And the doctors, do not think of going back. Do not relent.
No.
It is your CBA. It was signed. It is the government's own proposal to come down from 357,000 to 206. That was the government's proposal. If then the union agreed to the government's own proposal, why are they now deciding to change it midstream? And are trying to change it unilaterally because the CBAs provide moderation, modification, alteration, amendment of any CBA that has been signed. There is a procedure of how to go about it. Why is the government using unorthodox means to vary that particular CBA? And so, to the rest of the public servants, stand with the doctors. These are your brothers, are your sisters, and we are our own brother's keeper. Doctors, viva!
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 Thank you very much. My name is Grace Nyongesa. I'm the Vice Chair of Trade Union Congress Kenya. We serve the public sector unions, and we are here in solidarity with the doctors. Viva doctors!
Viva!
Viva KMPDU!
Viva!
We stand in solidarity with the doctors because the manner in which the doctors are being handled in this country is uncalled for. It is unnecessary. It is embarrassing. It is very sad for the government to stand out there and appear to be working when the doctors are on the street. If we don't have a healthy nation, then what do we have? What is left for Kenyans? When the doctors are crying, I have said mothers are crying. When mothers are crying, a whole family is crying and the whole nation is crying. Can somebody listen, wake up from their sleep and listen to the doctors? For as long as the doctors are on the street, the strike is gaining momentum. People are joining in solidarity with the doctors. And as public sector unions, we are here to stand in solidarity with the doctors. When somebody stands up and just makes roadside declarations about public servants coming from contract, from PNP
to contract,
then you are threatening the entire nation. It is civil servants, it's public servants that implement government policies and government
programs
in the government sector. So if you threaten them, then what are you saying? You are threatening a whole nation, you are threatening public servants. There is total unrest you are creating, which is unnecessary. Can somebody wake up and listen to the cry of doctors? It is legitimate. If you negotiate a CBA, sign it, register it, what else is left? Implement it. Honor the CBA. That's all the doctors are asking. They are not out here on frivolous claims. They are claiming what is rightfully theirs. The other day I had somebody compare the interns, the doctors, to any other. It is very embarrassing. Don't they understand what the training of a doctor entails? don't they understand? It is very embarrassing. Somebody else says, I didn't ask them to train as doctors. It is embarrassing.
Shame.
It is a shame.
Shame.
It is a shame.
Shame.
Shame on you.
Shame.
Making such declarations. Thank you.
Now that we are on strike, they keep victimizing each and every doctor. Threatening them with sacking letters, threatening them with messages, calling them every day. We want to say the doctors are on a strike that is protected by the courts. And the courts are giving directive to the same. Therefore, the hospitals should know and should be aware that doctors are exercising their rights. That there are no amount of threats or victimizations that will be met upon those doctors that they will cower to and get back to work. It is clear that we want that the Kenyatta National Referral Hospital and Kenyatta University Teaching and Referral Hospital to actually implement CBA to protect the rights of doctors as they work. Doctors who are demotivated cannot work in the hospitals. Secondly, they are threatened to hire quacks, and they have done so. So they should continue working with quacks as we resolve the issues in the strike. This is not Kenyatta University Teaching and Referral Hospital is no one's property. It's a government property, and it is taxpayers that pay the money and the loans from it.
Yes.
It's not from Olive Mugenda, not from anybody else. And therefore, they should not try to threaten any doctors. All the doctors will take a unified action against the facility until our issues are resolved. Thank you.
Welcome.
Viva!
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 Viva.
Yeah, thank you. My name is Peterson Washira. I'm the National Chair for Kenya Union of Clinic Officers. Let me say that here today, I want to thank our comrades and brothers from the other unions who have joined us. And we are here today to protect the dignity of the public servants. We have a government that holds everything in contempt, from the workers to the laws, to everything they're supposed to be implementing. And my message today is to the CS of the public service, CS Kuria. And I want to tell him, I want to school him, that we have laws in this country. We have laws that protect workers. We have laws that protect labor relations for workers. And such laws, we have the Employment Act and the Public Service Commission Act. And the ideology he's bringing is in contravention of the law. So I want to tell CS Kuria that we shall stand together. And together as workers, that is why we have unions to unite us. And as unions, as we stand together, he is not going to succeed in his plot to indignify the public service. And we know that in the health sector, we know the bigger scheme is to reduce all the salaries for health workers. They are starting with the interns so that later, once you are paid a mega pay during internship, then you are going to accept the same when it comes to the salary at the end of it. And they also want going forward to employ health workers on contracts. And we want to tell them that we shall not allow that.
Yes.
Whatever it takes. Even if we are going to be on strike for the whole year, we are ready.
Yes.
Until the government itself can be able to comply and obey the laws that they usually tell us that we should obey. Thank you.
Yes. Yes.
What a business opportunity.
The profound sadness that we are here, we are not pleased with the terms that the government is giving us. First of all, we want to say that it is not our pleasure to be in the strike, but we won't allow and we won't give the government space to trifle our future. We are in a place where the government wants to, is setting up cons and pros of bureaucracy that are now barring us from a better future. One of them being, there's a policy that now is barring us to join the unions as interns. We want to assure you that our cohesiveness will stand, and we won't allow this because it is the right of every cadre in this country to be in a trade union. Secondly, I want to tell you people that it is not worth it. We stay in school for 7 years, and for the 7 years academic years, we have 6 academic years, and you pay a fee of 636,000. I believe in the University of Nairobi, the self-sponsored students are the majority. If you compound this, it comes to a gross of 3.8 million, and this is just the fee. You haven't added any other cost. So is it worth it that after all this and all the struggles, you are paid only 47 to 70,000? I strongly believe that we won't allow this. It is not worth it. For you who hasn't still joined medicine and it's your dream, I want to tell you that this is a very dry land, and don't come here because it's not interesting anymore. Thank you. Comrades power!
Power!
Comrades power!
Power!
Solidarity forever!
Solidarity.
From all over the country, kutoka Turkana, kutoka Babu, kutoka Kisumu. Haya, tusonge, tusonge sasa, tusonge tu, tusonge sasa. Tusonge, tusonge, tusonge sasa. Tusonge, tusonge, tusonge sasa. kama ilivyo kawaida yetu na hamna yetu kutukifika ambapo ni makao ya kiserikali, tunaanza na national anthem. Kwa hivyo tutapiga tu national anthem, kisha tutaweza kuwakatikia hapa miondoko, tutaweza kushindana hapa miondoko kali kali. Asante sana. Haya, unatoa kwa kawaida yetu tunaimbanga the national anthem, kisha tunaenda pale East Africa, kisha tunarudi kwa Kenya Union of Clinicals national anthem. Kwa hivyo wakati huu tampea Mungu mwema kutoka kule Mombasa aweze kutuongoza kwa wimbo wa Kenya Union of Clinicals national anthem. Welcome sir.
Congrats pa! At ease. Okay, tunaimba kuso anthem kama desturi, mkono wa kulia hapa. Tunaanza. Mungu ibariki kuso yetu. Mungu ibariki kuso yetu. Viongozi wote wabariki, wanachama wote wabariki, wanachama wote wabariki. Ibariki kuso, ibariki kuso.
Kidogo. Thank you very much comrades. Ilivyo anda na kawaida yetu, tukifika tena kwa ofisi ya kiserikali tunajitambulisha, kisha tunasema tumefika kulingana na kipengee gani cha katiba yetu ya Kenya, na tuko hapa in the courtesy of Article 37 that allows every citizen of this republic to demonstrate, present a petition to a public office.
Kisha,
asante sana. Pia tuko hapa kwa sababu ya kipenge ama the Article 41 allows every citizen perform a union and participate in union activities. These are union activities.
you very much. Thank you. Na unajua tuko hapa parliament ambapo all the parliament
sana. Thank you very much, comrades. We are here, we are our national officials. I'm Bayene Moses, the National Trustee of Kenya Union of Clinic Officers. Kwa nafasi hii, ntampea katibu wetu wa Kenya Union of Officers. Gibore, aweze kutuambia pale parliament kama amepewa pesa ya entertainment. Kwa sababu, leo tumewaimbia parliamentarians.
Lakini tunataka kuambia kuwa maandamano ni kuwa kazini kwa sababu hiyo iko kwenye katiba yetu. Tumekuja hapa ili tukaweze kuongelesha wale ambaye ni viongozi wetu ambaye wanatengeneza katiba ama sheria zozote za Kenya, si ndio? Na wao watusikize, wajue kuna matatizo katika sekta yetu ya afya, si ndio? Tunasema hivi matatizo iliyopo sio sababu ya kanuni ama sheria ama katiba, ni kwa sababu ya wale ambaye ni magavana, ni ya sababu ya viongozi ambao hawajali wa Kenya. Tumelete ujumbe that this is an August house. We want them to ensure that they can enforce law and orders where the counties and the governors have decided that they will not honor any law in this country. Senio? Sisi tuko hapa kama maafisa tabibu na wale pia daktari bingo ambayo wako hapa, na tumesema kwamba shida zile ambazo zinatukumba sisi ndizo haso zinazowakumba Wakenya wengine wote wale wa chini, si ndio? Kama wanatusikiza, tunataka mabadiliko, na mabadiliko ni sasa hivi, na kama si sasa hivi hatutabanduka. Viongozi wengine watuongeleshe, alafu tunajua tumeshaelezwa. Leo hivi kuna yule ambaye anawakilisha rais anaitwa Head of Public Service. Ako na mkutano pande hii nyingine. So tutazunguka pale, alafu twende tufanye nini? Tuwasalimie. Na hapo kuna wale ambao tunaokota pesa zetu kama taxation, wanaitwa Ako pande hiyo, wao ndio hutumia na kuelekeza hela zetu. Basi tutaenda nini? Kuwasalimia na tuambie sekta ya afya haiendelei kwa sababu hawaja tupatia hela.
We say we have crossed the Rubicon. We say there's no turning back.
Yes.
There is no retreat.
Yes.
There is no surrender.
Yes.
We want the government to implement CBA for doctors.
Yes.
We want the government to sign the CBA for clinical officers.
Yes.
We want the government to pay. We have seen them treating us like second hand citizens of this country. And one thing we want to say, we will not allow it. For doctors, we are for the 8th day of the strike. For clinical officers, it's day 30. We are ready to go for 1 year.
Yeah.
They cannot reduce our salaries to go and pay cash.
Yeah.
We can't petition to the parliament and tell them they should do their job. The parliament should not be pocketed by the executive. We are Kenyans and we are saying we have our rights. We will be on strike until all our issues are implemented. Hospitals.
Yes.
The hospitals are built by government.
Yes.
But as we must work in those hospitals with the terms that we agree with.
Yes.
We cannot work in the hospital with their own terms.
Yes.
And therefore we leave the hospital until they agree to our terms.
Yes.
Until they agree to sign CBS.
Yes.
Until they agree to implement CBS.
Yes.
So from here we will proceed to Arambe House.
Yes.
And then we go home. Next week on Tuesday, we have a joint demonstration. Then to Ministry of Health,
yes.
To Parliament,
yes.
Then to COG.
Yes.
So next week, 9 a.m. Tuesday, Mandamano.
Tunajua representative wa serikali wako hapo KICC. Tuwapatie maneno pale. Nataka kurudisha kwa Bwana Moses kuongoza, tupatane pale kwa Public Service Commission.
kuna pia wengine wengi tunawashukuru. Lakini ilivyo handa na desturi yetu kama wananchi ambao wanaheshimu nchi, tukiweza kufika katika ofisi ya serikali tunaanza na wimbo wa kitaifa, kisha tunaanza na wimbo wa East Africa, kisha tunaweza kutegua viuno kidogo. Kwa hivyo DJ, naomba uweze kutupa our national anthem. 1, 2, 3, go! Sisi ni wazalendo na wapenda nchi, na sisi tunatii sheria hakika. Kisha tutaomba kula mambo aweze kufika hapa atuimbishe au anasema kidogo tu apate maji, apate kopo la maji. Lakini hapo tunasema ya kwamba kwa sababu the commissioners wako hapa ndani, na tunajua kwamba wamepewa entertainment allowance, na tunajua kuna mahali wanaenda kuimbiwa,
yeah.
Na sisi tumesema tuko hapa for free entertainment, lakini wataweza kutusea ile pesa ambao wamelipwa kwa invoice ya entertainment. Kwa hivyo ni sisi tutaomba uweze kutupa wimbo tafadhali, ambao tutadegwa viuno vyetu nikitaka kuvutika vijiji
vichangamfu.
much.